we're coming to talk to you about various opportunities for what you can do post-18, so obviously when you leave year 13. It's opportunities that you can volunteer abroad in different countries, get a lot of experience. It is important for us to give you an insight into the range of opportunities that there are available to you. We always put a lot of emphasis on the idea of apprenticeships and university, but there are loads of other opportunities as well. So I'm going to hand over to these two who are going to introduce themselves, and they're going to tell you all about what they've been up to. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sam.
Good morning, you guys. So my name is Micky. You're probably wondering what Molaweli means. It does mean hello in South Africa. There's 11 languages in South Africa. Isi, Kosa is one word. I still find it quite hard to pronounce Isi, Kosa. So Isi, Kosa is one of the 11 languages, and Molaweli means hello.
My name is Anisah, guys. Kamarato. I did a trip in Bangladesh, but I'll just give you guys a bit of a better idea of why I'm here. I always thought I needed to volunteer overseas, but I never knew how to do it. So ICS is one of those programs that you don't need to be able to quite for anything like that. All you need to do is show that you actually care and you want to make a difference in the world. And ICS will take care of everything else for you. So it's really dependent on how much you want to get with the bigger picture.
Okay, so I think since I mentioned a few things, as in what you've gained from the experience of Chatterley, but here's a few more. So you can challenge yourself, you can gain great new skills for your CV, experience a new culture, which is fantastic. So myself, I actually lived with a host family. I lived with three other South African people who showed me, you know, more about their culture, and we learned a lot from each other, just from kind of, you know, kind of swapping of, I guess, experiences from our cultures and background. And you definitely make lifelong friends. So that's one of the main things that I took away from the experience. I met some incredible people out there who are just really open-minded.
Not even people out there, people all across England end up going away with, and you'll make friends in Wales.
Yeah. I've got a friend in Hull, Newcastle, Cheltenham. These are places that I probably did not know existed. Or Cheltenham and Hull. But yeah, so it's great that you get to meet a lot of different people from different backgrounds.
So these are some of the places you can visit. This is with White Hair International. You can go to Guatemala, Togo, Bangladesh is where I went. So there's lots of different places, and depending on the country you go to, you're going to impact the community in a specific way that's relevant to the actual country itself. So the main key is not just going over there and deciding this is what I'm going to do, this is how I'm going to help. The main key is actually going there, speaking to the local communities that actually know what needs to be done and assisting them. So you're actually making a value difference for the community and not just coming in there, having an experience and then walking away. You're actually going to make an impact.
One of the main things I think about the ICS program is focused on sustainable change, which means that it's change that can kind of remain, you know, it can continue within the community even after we leave. So myself, I work for Freshman Development, you see the logo in the bottom right hand corner. They work in 7 different countries, so South Africa, Tanzania, Uganda, Nepal, India, Zimbabwe and Zambia. So you don't actually get to choose where you want to go. I think myself, we were allowed to pick, I think, one or two of your top options, but it really depends on when you're available in terms of how they place you and where they place you. So this is just a bit about what the volunteers can do. So they get involved with health, kind of help with skills and jobs, help with any emergencies, promote peace and justice. Okay, so this is a picture from my experience of some of the local children in the community.
Okay, so this is a photo of a local village called Madam Bibi Hut. This is in Bangladesh. And it's a rural community that I went to go volunteer and help with. So the main focus there was helping women with their environment, because a lot of them were stay-at-home mums. What we did was set up a sewing project where women could actually learn new skills on how to sew and then actually make small businesses from that. So they actually felt that they're providing an income for their family, and believe it or not, that actually helps with stopping domestic violence, because once they're generating an income, they're getting some sort of sense of empowerment and they feel like they have more of a say. It takes kind of domestic violence for husbands. So little things you may not think, teaching someone how to sew, you might not think that's something that would make such a difference, but it actually did. It gave people more of a meaning and felt like they've actually got something to do.
So this is a picture, again, in the community. My community was known as Hodes. So this is their sports day. As you can imagine, if you think about the facilities you guys have on sports day in comparison to this, these guys are making do with their school tables, and it's incredible, you know, how much fun they have, you know, just the resources that they have, limited resources that they have.
This is just
another
photo of my
team. Okay, so this is just another photo of the children left, some girls in the community up here, they're looking very beautiful with flowers. And on the left is an image of the lady, an older lady, outside a supermarket. transporting onions on that desk.
I'm not squashing.
You're right, it is quite a squash. But yeah, so it just kind of just shows, you know, their transports are limited, but they really make do with what they have.
That's just the local
organ
where we volunteered
and
gave our time as well.
So we held sessions, me and my team, we held sessions in one of the schools over there. We had at least one or two sessions every day of the week. That's the last week, that's 12 weeks. Okay, so we're going to show you a little video.
The main reason that ICS was set up was, first of all, for the Millennium Development Goals. I don't know if you're aware of them, but they were goals set up in 2022 countries to help tackle poverty. So just a couple of weeks ago now, the deadline finished and a new goal was set up, and the UN set up the Sustainable Development Goals to further achieve that, to eradicate poverty by 2030. I had the privilege of going to the Department of International Development to actually give some input on these goals coming from the youth side, so I'll just give you a short clip to explain. Get a small living allowance, and you'll also part with a family. there and you actually live there, you become part of their family, and that's the best way for you to take in the culture and actually get to know the way of life.
Okay, so here's how to apply. I've got some leaflets here as well from charities that I went with. So if any of you guys are interested, the information will be here. Alternatively, we'll be sitting around for 5 to 10 minutes so you can get this information from us where to come to apply. That will be the link of where to go to apply. It's not going to work. We had a little video here, video, but it's not going to work. Are we running out of time?
Yeah, we are, yeah.
Okay. One last thing.
So as you guys go out, you can just be like this video knitting with the mirror.
It's just a little bit from my career, which we went together last night.
After school on Tuesday. Unfortunately, about 7 or 8 people actually arrived at that particular point. So, if you have not had a timetable, you need to be able to resit maths and English. If you've not had a timetable, I need to be able to see you now, just about to go through 1 or 2 things. Can I also, just to add what's actually gone on into there, we do community service inside school. After watching that feels a really poor relation to the kind of things that you can do to make a difference. The key thing about that video for me was that one small action can change people's lives. That's exactly the same inside school. One kindness, one small action, one piece of support can make a difference. And I would encourage all of you to be able to, if you're not going to do something like this, to be able to look for other opportunities you can do. It helps that roundedness, which is so important for developing into later life. So, can I just pass my hand? That was amazing. I'm very brave about what she said go and do, so I hope people actually be inspired by that. Very kind of you to do that. What I actually need now is 2 things about to happen. Those of you who are going to be able to actually ask questions probably need to be able to do that by Mr. Evans. Those of you who are going off to your lessons, make sure you apologise to your teachers. And most importantly of all, those people who haven't got a timetable shown when their maths or their English GCSE recent is need to see me now for about 5 minutes, please.
12 minutes to read that.
Okay. It's on. Yep. Smile for the camera, bro. It's on.
Hey, smile.